Welcome to this DREAMS tutorial about partitioned system scheduling. My name is Alfons Crespo from the Technical University of Valencia, and this tutorial will cover some ideas about partitioned system and scheduling entities, about the computational model. We will show also some examples. We will speak about the hypervisor scheduling, and finally we will elaborate some conclusions. All of you know about partitioned systems, that are, we have a set of functions in our system organized in independent applications. Each set of activities related to a part of the application can require some operating system, different operating system, with a real-time operating system or general-purpose operating system, even some minimal runtime or bar applications. Some application can require real-time constraints or safety constraints, so we have different requirements related to applications. Each set of activities with an operating system are organized in partitions that avoids the operating system and the internal activities of the application as allocated in that partition. Each partition itself can require different level of certification, and all these partitions are supported by a partitioning kernel or hypervisor. This is an example with the hypervisor, in that case is Stratum. We have a multi-core hardware platform here, and on top of that we have several applications that are included in different partitions. In that case we require, for instance, an APA like ARINC 653 or an RTOS with an APA that is POSIX, or with just the DREAMS abstraction layer, DRAL, or ADA application with GNAT. So from the point of view of the scheduling, we are going to discuss about which entities are handled by each level. The hypervisor schedules partitions. A partition for the hypervisor is like some code, internal code, with an entry point, and one of the features of that is that the hypervisor doesn't know the internals of the partition. It means it doesn't know if there is an operating system inside of the partition, or there are tasks or threads. And the hypervisor applies a scheduling policy to schedule partitions. If we move to the next level, partition, for instance, with OS, it schedules tasks or threads and applies a scheduling policy defined by the operating system. And if we deal with a partition without OS, a bare partitions, it is integrated by only one single thread, and there is no scheduling policy, or in some cases we could apply some cyclic scheduling. So if we move to multicore, the hypervisor in that case can provide as many virtual CPUs as real CPUs we have in the real hardware, offers these virtual CPUs to partitions, and can use a uniform or non-uniform scheduling policy per core. So we can have a core with a scheduling policy, cyclic, or another core scheduled under other policy. In the partition with OS, we have the same, and in that case, as we can use several virtual CPUs, we can have monocore or multicore partitions, and the operating system will provide a scheduling policy. And if we deal with partition without OS, we can have also several virtual CPUs. And from the point of view of the execution, we can have one thread per virtual CPU. This is an example. We have three partitions. These are monocore, this is B-core. We have a multi-core, quad-core platform. This partition uses virtual CPU 0, is the abstraction provided by the hypervisor, and the hypervisor is in charge of allocate that partition to a real core. That virtual CPU to another core, for instance, and these two virtual CPUs to two different real cores. So the allocation of these virtual CPUs is provided by the hypervisor, by Stratum in that case. So if we speak about scheduling, we can say that at hypervisor level we can use a cyclic schedule or a server-based scheduling policy. This server-based can be periodic or deferable or aperiodic. We will discuss more about that. If we speak about partitions, a partition can execute, can perform a schedule based on cyclic schedule or fixed priority schedule using a rate monotonic or deadline monotonic, or can use a dynamic priority schedule based on ADF or LLF. This as we know in all operating systems. If we now move to analyze what we consider the computational model. The computational model, we can say that we have a system. A system is includes a set of partitions, includes a hypervisor scheduling policy. It handles several CPUs, and it uses an allocation policy in order to allocate partition to cores. If we detail what we consider a partition has a criticality level, has a set of tasks, has a scheduling policy, and handles one or several virtual CPUs. If we move to task, a task has the classical parameters with real-time task like worst-case execution time, period, deadline, offset. We are going to see some examples. For instance, we have a system with two partitions applying a cyclic policy, one core, no allocation, only one core. And we have two partitions, one with two tasks applying a fixed priority schedule using one virtual CPU because we have one core. And we have a second partition that has no operating system and uses this task. These are the parameters of the task of partition 1 and partition 2. And this is a possible schedule of that. If we enlarge that, we can see that the CPU 0 executes partition 1. In partition 1 is the operating system who schedules the internal task. Then we execute, or the CPU 0 executes the second partition. In that case, we have the execution of the different partitions in that core. And we can see that this is the description of the cyclic schedule for that. For instance, this temporal window defines that we start at 0 in a MAF or major frame of 100 milliseconds, starting at 0 offset with respect to the origin, and a duration of 11 microseconds, executing partition 0, that is the partition 1 that we have referred here. So this is an example of the cyclic schedule. Another example is with multicore is a more simple example. I have three partitions, monocore partitions, and I want to execute each partition in one core. So in that case, it's very easy to define a task associated to the to each partition with a period and a budget. In that case, the same value. So we execute in a core always the same partition. So in that case, we allocate a partition full in the full execution of a CPU. A more complex example is that we have a multi-core with two cores. We have a partition one with three tasks. We have a partition two with three tasks, and we have a partition three with two tasks or two threads and two virtual CPUs. So we want to execute something in parallel here. So in that case, these are the definition of the task inside of partition one, partition two, and partition three, that are two tasks that we want to execute in parallel. And in that case, if we enlarge this, we see here that we execute at the same time the partition three, and then partition one in one core, partition two in another core, etc. So we have here the allocation of that partitions to cores, and here the internal of each one. What we need to specify at the hypervisor level is that scheduling of CPU 0 and CPU 1. Now we are going to discuss about which are the policies for the hypervisor, which policy. We said previously that is cyclic or server, and here we are discuss more about that. First, which are the requirements that we require for the hypervisor? First, we want to have temporal isolation of partitions, avoid the impact in time of one partition to the other partitions. And also we are interested in incremental certification, what means that if we have a system with several partitions and we modify one partition, we want just to recertify the partition that has been modified without affecting the other partitions. In order to fulfill that requirements, we have policies, and one policy is the cyclic schedule. So we define an offline plan in order to execute our system. One of the things is how is it generated? So we need tools in order to help us in order to generate that static plan. We also can define several plans in order to cover multi-mode systems that can be in different modes and execute different set of tasks. We want that the policy or the global behavior of the system be not impacted by the modification of one partition. So we want to, in some way, to maintain the schedule as we had and was certified in some partitions and modified just the behavior of one of them. And what we can say that is that the system is scheduled on the basis on the worst case scenarios. So we generate a cyclic schedule based on the worst execution type. So we generate fixed worst case scenarios for the execution. The other option is use server-based schedule. In the case of server-based schedule, it is a schedule the hypervisor could apply some partition attribute like importance, priority, or other attributes of the partition. What we need is to constrain the execution, to bound the execution of a partition, and it can be, this is the reason we use server-based schedule. This server-based is compressed into parameters, the period and the budget of the server. What one of the problems with, that we have with the server-based schedule is that the schedule changes, can change according to the partition needs. If it executes more or less, the other partition can advance the execution. Of course, there is a budget, maximum budget, but the schedule is changing. So it presents some difficulties to the incremental certification. That is one of the issues that we want to deal with that. In conclusions, we can say that hierarchical scheduling partitioned system is an important issue. We have different levels of schedule dealing with the hypervisor of the partitions, and we have to consider both in order to analyze our system. The first level is the hypervisor level, requires to bound the execution of this partition, are the entities that we execute, so we need to perform a static scheduling like cyclic scheduling or a server-based schedule. One important issue in multicore is that different scheduling policies can be used depending on the core. Each core can be scheduled according to a different policy. We should say that the generation of cyclic scheduling is an open challenge because we deal with temporal constraints. We require some overhead optimization, interference optimization. We have to reduce that in multicore system. So we need the help of tools and theory that support that. We, in other videos, we will see about that. And we need to perform a schedulability analysis of the system. And again, the tools are important in order to deal with that. In other presentation, the concrete tool will describe the model and how the schedulability analysis is performed. This is all. Thank you and thanks.